أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والزاريات ضربا فالحاملات وقرا فالجاريات يسرا فالمقسمات أمرا إنما توعدون لصادق وإن الدين لواقع. صدق الله العظيم. Before we proceed with Surah Al-Zariyat, I forgot to tell you that out of the three Madani Surahs of the last group, two were definitely in the form of a pair. Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Surah Al-Fath. But Surah Al-Hujarat was solitary, unique. It has no pair. In the same way, out of these seven Makki Surahs, the first of which was Surah Al-Kaf, this Surah Kaf is unique and solitary. But the rest of the six Surahs are divisible into three pairs. And you will see that the same relationship between Surah Al-An'am and Surah Al-A'raf. In one surah, you will find At-Tazkir bi Ayyamillah. In the other, At-Tazkir bi Ala'illah. So for two groups, it is very evident. But the third and final group, that is a very unique group in the whole of Quran, we shall discuss later when we reach there, inshallah. Wazariyat-e Zarwan, by the scattering winds that scatter dust. We have one surah before which started in this style. Wasafat safan, fazajrat zajran, faltariyat sikran. So that was Surah As-Saffat. And there we know that it was the angels, you know, who were mentioned over there. But here, these are the winds. And you may note it, this rih, the Arabic for wind, rih. And ruh, for the soul, for the spirit, they are also very close. Waw and ya, they are actually huruf illat, weak alphabets of the Arabic language that take each other's place alternatingly. As I told you, nar and noor are very close to each other. So ruh and rih are also very close. By the scattering winds that scatter dust, then they are bearing a blood, that is of the clouds. Then they are distributing the affairs, that is whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands, the rain comes. Others you don't keep dry. إِنَّمَا تُوْعَدُونَ لَصَادِقٌ. What you are being promised is surely true. وَإِنَّ الدِّينَ لَوَاقِعٌ. And definitely, the recompense is sure to happen. This is the main theme of these surahs. إِنَّمَا تُوْعَدُونَ لَوَاقِعٌ. إِنَّمَا تُوْعَدُونَ لَصَادِقٌ وَإِنَّ الدِّينَ لَوَاقِعٌ. Whatever is being promised with you, that a day will come when you will have to stand before your Lord for that grand accountability, and then you know you will have to face the results of your deeds. إِنَّمَا تُوْعَدُونَ لَصَادِقٌ وَإِنَّ الدِّينَ لَوَاقِعٌ. What you are promised is surely true, and the recompense is sure to come. وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْحُبُكِ. By the heaven full of paths. إِنَّكُمْ لَفِي قَوْلٍ مُخْتَلِفٍ. Surely you are at variance in your sayings. يُوفَكُ عَنْهُ مَنْ أُفِكَ. Turned away from this truth is he who has been diverted. قُتِلَ الْخَرَّاصُونَ. These conjecturers will perish. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي غَبْرَةٍ سَعُونَ. who are in an abyss and neglectful. يَسْأَلُونَ أَيَّانَ يَوْمُ الدِّينِ. They ask, when shall be the day of recompense? You say it will come. When it will come? يَوْمَهُمْ عَلَى النَّارِ يُفْتَنُونَ. It will be the day when they shall be punished in the fire. ذُوقُوا فِتْنَتَكُمْ. And it will be said, now taste your punishment. هَذَا الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ بِهِ تَسْتَعْجَلُونَ. This is what you sought to be hastened. إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونَ. Surely the God-fearing will be in the gardens and springs. آخِذِينَ مَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ. They'll be receiving that which their Lord will give them. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُحْسِنِينَ. They were before this, before coming here, in the hereafter, in the world, in their previous life, they were excellent in deeds, محسنين. كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون. They used to sleep but little at night. They used to keep awake. قم الليل إلا قليلا نصفه وبنقص منه قليلا. وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. And again before the dawn, they used to ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وفي أموالهم حق للسائل والمحروم. And in their wealth, there was a necessary portion for the beggar and the deprived. وَفِي الْأَرْضِ آيَاتٌ لِلْمُوقِنِينَ. And in the earth, there are signs for those who are convinced or who want to be convinced. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ. And within your own selves also, there are our signs. أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Don't you see? Can't you peep down into your hearts? وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. And in the heaven is your sustenance and that which you are promised. فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. So by the Lord of heaven and earth, إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌ مِثْلَ مَا أَنْتُمْ تَنْتِقُونَ. This is surely the truth, just as you are speaking. Just we are talking to each other in the same way. This day of judgment will come. هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ ضَيْفِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ. Has the story of the honored guests of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam came to you? Is dakhalu alayhi, the angels, you know, which were sent to bring that chastisement to the two cities, twin cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, which were destroyed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They first of all came to Ibrahim. We have read it several times. Is dakhalu alayhi, when they entered upon him, faqalu salama, they said, salam, peace. قَالَ سَلَامٌ. Now in reply, Ibrahim also said, peace. قَوْمٌ مُنْكَرُونَ. But you are a people unknown to me. I don't know you. Maybe this he said in his heart only. فَرَاغَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ. So he turned to his family. فَجَاءَ بِهِجْلٍ سَمِينٍ. And he brought a roasted calf. فَقَرَّبَهُ إِلَيْهِمْ. And he laid it before them. قَالُوا لَا قَالَ أَلَا تَعْقُلُونَ. He said, do you not eat? فَأَوْجَسَ مِنْهُمْ خِيفَةً. So he conceived a fear from them. Because in those days, it was the practice of people who went somewhere to kill somebody. They won't taste the salt of that person whom they are going to kill. So Ibrahim thought, alayhi salatu wasalam, that they want to do some harm to me, that is why they are not eating, you know, from my table. فَأَوْجَسَ مِنْهُمْ خِيفَةً. So he conceived a fear from them. قَالُوا لَا تَخَفْ. They said, don't have any fear. وَبَشَّرُوهُ بِغُلَامٍ عَلِيمٍ. And they gave him the good tidings of a knowledgeable son. فَرَحَضَرَتِ إِسْحَاقَ عَلِيمٍ. And for Hazrat Ismail, Haleem. As I told you, this word Haleem appears in the Quran either for Allah or twice for Ibrahim and once for Ismail. For nobody else in the whole of Quran. But compared to Ismail, he was termed Haleem. Here, Ishaq is termed Haleem. Haleem, knowledgeable. فَأَقْبَلْتِ امْرَأَتُهُ فِي سَرَّةٍ. Then came forward his wife, Hazrat Sara radiallahu ta'ala anhu, with loud grumbling. فَسَكَّتْ وَجْهَهَا. And she smote her face, struck her face. وَقَالَتْ عَجُوزًا عَقِيمٌ. And she said, an old barren woman. She was nearly 99 at that time of age, and all the life she had been barren. Hazrat Ibrahim was 100 years. So she said, is it possible? What are you saying? Ajuzu naqib. I'm very old, and then I have been barren all the life. Qalu kazalik. They said, this will happen. Qala rabbuke. This is the saying of your Lord. Innahu huwa al-hakim al-alim. Verily, he is the wise, the knower. Qala fama khatbukum ayyuha al-mursaloon. Now Ibrahim asked them, what's your mission? O people who have been sent, O messengers. Qalu inna arsalna ila qawmi mujrimeen. They said, we have been sent upon a guilty people. لِنُرْسِلَ عَلَيْهِمْ حِيَارَةٌ مِّنْ تِينٍ, so that we may send down upon them stones of clay. مُسَوَّمَةً عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ, marked from your Lord for the criminals. مُسَوَّمَةً عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لِلْمُسْرِفِينَ. فَأَخْرَجْنَا مَنْ كَانَ فِيهَا مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Then we took out such believers as were there in that city. فَمَا وَجَدْنَا فِيهَا غَيْرَ بَيْتٍ مِّنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. But we didn't find in that city except one house of the Muslims, house of Lut alayhi salatu wasalam. He himself and his two daughters, that's all. Not even his own wife. وَتَرَكْنَا فِيهَا آيَةً لِلَّذِينَ يَخَافُونَ الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمَ. And we left therein a sign for those who fear the painful chastisement. وَفِي مُوسَى. And also there are signs in the story of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. إِذَا صَلْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ بِسُلْطَانٍ مُبِينٍ. When we sent him to Firaun with the manifest authority. فَتَوَلَّا بِرُكْنِهِ. He turned away arrogantly on account of his might, power. وَقَالَ سَاحِرٌ أَوْ مَجْنُونَ. And he said about Musa, either he is a sorcerer or a madman. فَأَخَذْنَاهُ وَجُنُودَهُ. So we seized him and his hosts and armies. فَنَبَذْنَاهُمْ. And we threw them fil yam, in the sea. وَهُوَ mulim, and he was blameworthy. وَفِي عَادٍ, in the same way, there are signs in the story of Aad. إِذَا صَلَّى عَلَيْهِمُ الرِّيحَ الْعَقِيمَ. When we sent against them a barren wind, مَا تَذَرُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ أَتَتْ عَلَيْهِ. It left nothing it came upon. إِلَّا جَعَلَتْهُ كَالرَّمِيمِ. But it made it like ashes. وَفِي سَمُودَ, in the same way, in the story of Samud, إِذْ قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَمَتَّعُوا حَتَّاهِينَ. When it was said to them, now you can enjoy the comforts for a while. فَعَتَوْا نَمْرِ رَبِّهِمْ. They revolted against the command of their Lord. فَأَخَذَتْهُمُ السَّائِقَةُ وَهُمْ يَنْظُرُونَ. And so a thunderbolt seized them while they were beholding. فَمَا اسْتَطَاعُوا مِنْ قِيَامٍ وَمَا كَانُوا مُنْتَصِرِينَ. Now they couldn't stand up, they couldn't rise up, and nor they were able to defend themselves or to take revenge for themselves. وَقَوْمَ نُوحٍ مِنْ قَبْلٍ. And before them, the nation of Nuh, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا فَاسِقِينَ. Verily, they were also transgressing people. Now these were the Amba'ur Rusul, Lut, then Hud, Nuh, Saleh, all have been mentioned. Hazrat Musa, they have been mentioned. But about Ibrahim, not of that type, not Amba'ur Rusul, but only an event that the angels came to him and they had a conversation. وَالسَّمَاءَ بَنَيْنَاهَا بِأَيْدٍ وَإِنَّا لَمُوسِعُونَ. And the heaven, we have made it with our own hands. What does it mean? With our own might. وَإِنَّا لَمُوسِعُونَ. And we are able to extend the vastness of the space thereof. We can expand. Now this comes, or we should say, the theory of expanding universe comes very near to this. We have created the heaven, and we can expand it. So that expansion, theory of the expanding universe, now this has come very close to this ayah of Quran. وَالْأَرْضَ فَرَشْنَاهَا. And the land, earth, we spread it. فَنِعْمَ الْمَاهِدُونَ. So how excellent spreaders are we. وَمِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. And out of everything we have created pairs, that you may be admonished. Then what is the admonishment or reminding in this reality that everything has been created in pairs? There should be a pair of this life. Life of this world and the life of hereafter. They go to make something complete. Otherwise this life is incomplete. Here, whosoever doing wrong, he is not punished. Whosoever is doing good, he doesn't get the reward. So this is an illogical life of this world. It will be completed and become logical only when you add to it the life of the hereafter. So this is a couple. This earth and the sky, they are a couple. From there water comes and then earth gives out its vegetation. Just as man and woman, they both go to make, you know, fulfill a purpose of procreation. Neither only male can procreate, nor only female can procreate, except Mary, Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam. But that was an exception by the command of Allah. But you need a male and a female for procreation. So this is everything we have created in pairs, that you may be admonished and reminded. فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. So run you towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنِّي لَكُمْ مِنْهُ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. Verily, I am a plain warner from him to you. وَلَا تَجْعَلُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرٍ. And don't set up with Allah another God. إِنِّي لَكُمْ مِنْهُ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. Surely, I am a plain warner from him to you. كَذَلِكَ مَا أَتَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ رَسُولٍ. إِلَّا قَالُوا سَاحِرٌ أَوْ مَجْنُونَ. In the same way, whenever a messenger came to those who were before them, they always said, either he is a sorcerer or a madman, مَجْنُون. أَتَوَاصَوْا بِهِ. Had they handed over some legacy, those people of the ancient had given this will to them, that you should also say the same to your messenger, which we said for our messenger, بَلُمْ قَوْمٌ تَاغُونَ. They are a transgressing people. فَتَوَلَّ عَنْهُمْ. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you turn away from them. فَمَا أَنْتَ بِمَلُومٍ. You are not going to be reproached. If they are not believing in you, if they are not responding to your da'wah, your call, no blame to you. You have to do your duty and that's all. They will be blamed. They will be blameworthy. They will be caught. They will be seized. They will be punished. You are not going to be reproached. وَذَكِّرْ. But go on admonishing. Go on reminding. فَإِنَّ الزِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Because if this admonition or reminding is not benefiting these people, it definitely benefits those who believe. Repetition, repetition. For the mu'mineen, reminding and reminding and reminding. So that they are reminded again and again of their covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of their consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I have not created the jinn and the humans except for the purpose that they should obey me, they should worship me, they should love me, they should adore me. This Friday, you know, I gave this sermon, Friday sermon on this subject, this ayah. This is the purpose of creation. And I gave the Persian couplet of Shaykh Sadi rahmatullah alayh. Zindagi amat barae bandagi. Zindagi be bandagi sharmindagi. This life has been given to us for worshipping and loving and obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I explained what is ibadah? Total obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Total. But with extreme love for him. These two things go to make ibadah. Total obedience. You have love, but you are not obeying. This is cancelled. You are obeying, but not loving. This is also cancelled. Because you obey even the tyrants, even the dictators, even the oppressors. Is obeying Allah like that? No. Obey him. But this obedience has to be total. From the depths of your hearts. Out of extreme love for him. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ. I don't want any sustenance from them وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَن يُطْعِمُونَ. I don't want that they should feed me. إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الرَّزَاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. On the contrary, Allah is Himself the bestower of sustenance and the Lord of power and ever strong. فَإِنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا ذُنُوبَ مِثْلَ ذُنُوبِ أَصْحَابِهِمْ. So those who do evil shall have their own portion, like the portion of their companions of the past. What happened to them will happen to these people also. فَلَا يَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. So let them not hasten it. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِيَوْمِهِمُ الَّذِينَ يُوَعَدُونَ. So woe to those who disbelieve for that day of theirs which they are promised. Surah At-Tur. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. At-Tur. By the Mount of Tur, وَكِتَابٍ مَسْتُورٍ, and by the book inscribed, فِي رَقٍ مَنْشُورٍ, in a parchment unrolled, وَالْبَيْتِ الْمَعْمُورِ, and the house always filled by angels. It is on the seventh heaven, the replica of Baytullah, that is on the seventh heaven, Baytul Ma'mur. Always, you know, angels are circle ambulating around it, just as, you know, this tawaf goes on in the Baytullah al-Haram. وَالسَّقْفِ الْبَرْفُوعِ, by the roof which is elevated, that is the heaven. وَالْبَحْرِ الْمَسْجُورِ, and by the sea which is swarming. إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقِعِ. Now all these oaths are on this. Verily, surely, certainly, the punishment from your Lord is to come. It will come. مَا لَهُ مِنْ دَافِهِ. There is none to avert it. يَوْمَ تَمُورُ السَّمَاءُ مَوْرًا. Now a description of that. زَلْزَلَةُ السَّاعَةُ. On the day when the heaven will shake with an awful shaking. وَتَسِيرُ الْجِبَالُ سَيْرًا. And the mountains will move away with an awful movement. فَوَيْلٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْمُكَذِّبِينَ. So woe on that day to the disbelievers. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي خَوْضٍ يَلْعَبُونَ. Who in their vain talk are playing, not paying heed to what the messenger is saying, not considering it. يَوْمَ يُدْعَوْنَ إِلَىٰ نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ دَعَىٰ. But on the day when they will be pushed to the hellfire with a dreadful pushing. هَذِهِ النَّارُ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ. This is that fire which you had been belying. أَفَسِحْرٌ هَذَا. Is this a sorcery? Is this a magic? أَمَنْتُمْ لَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Or are you not seeing it with your eyes? إِسْلَوْهَا. Now enter it. فَاسْبِرُوا أَوْ لَا تَسْبِرُوا. Then bear it patiently or don't bear it. Go on crying. سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. This will be equal to you. إِنَّمَا تُجْزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Surely you are being rewarded and recompensed for what you used to do. إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَعِيمٍ. On the other hand, the God-fearing people will be in the gardens in bliss. فَاكِهِينَ بِمَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ. Rejoicing in what their Lord will be giving to them. وَوَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ. And their Lord will save them from the chastisement of the hellfire. Kulu washrabu hani'an. Eat and drink pleasantly. Bima kuntum ta'amaloon. For what you had been doing. Muttaqeena ala surur masufa. Declining on the couches which will be placed in rows. Wazawwajnahum bihurin een. And we shall espouse them with wide-eyed huris. Wallazina amanu wattaba'athum zulliyatuhum bi'imanin. And those who believe, and their children, their offspring, also follow them in faith. Al-haqna bihim zurriyatahum. We shall join with them their offsprings. Wama alatnahum min amalihim min shay. And we shall not diminish anything of their deeds. That is, if the father, he has the right to go to a higher jannah. The sons and daughters, they are mu'min. This is the condition. But they are not up to that level. So they can't go to that level. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of those who deserve the higher level, He will raise the level of the sons and daughters, progeny, and He will take them to the father or the parents, mother, without diminishing the level of the original. They will not come down to be with their offsprings, but the offsprings will be taken up. كُلُّ مْرَيْمْ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِينَ. Every man is pledged against what he earned. وَأَمْدَدْنَاهُمْ بِفَاكِهَةٍ وَلَحْبٍ مِمَّا يَشْتَعُونَ. And we shall aid them with fruits and meat, whatever they desire. يَتَنَازَعُونَ فِيهَا كَاسًا. And they will be snatching from one each other in playing the cup from each other. لَا لَغْبٌ فِيهَا وَلَا تَعْسِيمٌ. In the wine of that cup, there will be no vain talk nor sin. وَيَتُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ غِلْمَانُ لَهُمْ. And their own boys, youth, will be going round them. And these boys will be كَانَّهُمْ لُؤْلُؤٌ مَكْنُونٌ, as if they are hidden pearls. وَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ. And now some of them will turn to the other and question. قَالُوا إِنَّا كُنَّا قَبْلُ مِي فِي أَهْلِنَا مُشْفِقِينَ. Now they are in Jannah, but they are saying to each other, surely we were, before coming here, in that world, in our families, we were ever fearful of the hereafter. We didn't know what will happen to us. We were not sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our sins. Last night we read, وَإِنَدْرِي مَا يُفَعَلُ بِي وَلَا بِكُمْ. I don't know what will be done to me or to you. So the true believer is always fearing here. He never has the confidence that I have done very good deeds, so I deserve nothing, nothing of that sort. The Prophet once said, nobody will be able to enter Jannah on the basis of his deeds only, unless the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pulls him up. And somebody asked, even you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is this rule applicable to you also? He said, yes, to me also. إِلَّا أَن تَغَمَّدَنِي رَبِّي بِرَحْمَتِهِ. Except that Allah covers me with His mercy, even I won't be able. So there's nothing, you know, that we should be sure. إِنَّا كُنَّا قَبْلُ فِي أَهْلِنَا مُشْفِقِينَ فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. So Allah has favored us. بَوَقَانَ عَذَابَ السَّمُومِ. And He has saved us from the chastisement of the burning wind. إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلُ نَدْعُوهُ. But in that life also, yes, we used to call upon Him. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْبَرُّ الرَّحِيمُ. Verily He is the most kind and the most merciful. فَذَكِّرْ فَمَا أَنْتَ بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ بِكَاهِنٍ أَوْ وَلَا مَجْنُونٍ. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you go on reminding them, admonishing them, because you are not from the blessings of your Lord, neither a soothsayer nor a madman. أَمْ يَقُولُنَا شَاعِرٌ نَتَرَبَّصُ بِهِ رَيْبَ الْمَنُونَ. Are they saying that he is a poet and we await some calamity of time to befall on him? قُلْ تَرَبَّصُوا فَإِنِّي مَعَاكُمْ مِنَ الْمُتَرَبِّسِينَ. Say to them, await, I shall also be waiting with you. أَمْ تَامُرْهُمْ عَلَامُهُمْ بِهَذَا. Do their intellects tell them this thing, that this person is mad or poet? أَبْهُمْ قَوْمٌ تَاغُونَ. Or they are rebellious. Their own intellects are not testifying to this, but out of their rebellious, you know, attitude, they are saying this. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ تَقَوَّلَهُ بَلْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Do they say he has invented it? Nay, they do not agree. فَلْيَاتُوا بِحَدِيثٍ مِثْلِهِ. If they say that he has forged it, he has composed it, he has written it, فَلْيَاتُوا بِحَدِيثٍ مِثْلِهِ إِنْ كَانُوا صَادِقِينَ. If they are truthful, that they should bring forth a discourse or a recital like this. أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ. Very important ayah. Were they created by none? Or are they the creators? Did you create yourself? No. Could you be created without any creator? No. There can be no answer except no. أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ Have they created the heavens and the earth? بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ But they don't believe and they are convinced, not convinced of anything. أَمْ إِنَّهُمْ خَزَائِنُ رَبِّكَ Do they possess the treasures of your Lord? أَمْ هُمُ الْمُسَيْطِرُونَ Or are they the dispensers, the distributors? أَمْ لَهُمْ سُلَّمٌ يَسْتَمِعُونَ فِيهِ Have they got any stairway, any ladder, in which they listen to the world of the unseen? فَلْيَاتِ مُسْتَمِعُهُمْ بِسُلْطَانِ مُبِينٍ So let any one of them who listens, he should bring a clear authority thereof. أَمْ لَهُ الْبَنَاتُ وَلَكُمُ الْبُنُونَ Are for him daughters and for you sons. أَمْ تَسَأَلُهُمْ أَجْرًا Do you ask Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم from them any wage, any reward? فَهُمْ مِنْ مَغْرَمِ مُسْقَلُونَ And they have been overburdened by the debt, by your demand. أَمْ إِنَّهُمُ الْغَيْبُ فَهُمْ يَكْتُبُونَ Do they have the knowledge of the unseen and they are writing it? أَمْ يُرِيدُونَ كَيْدًا Are they trying to plot and conspire against Muhammad? فَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا هُمُ الْمَكِيدُونَ But they are themselves caught in a plot. أَمْ لَهُمْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ Do they have any God except Allah? سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ أَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ Allah is glorified from what they are associating with Him. وَهِنْ يَرَوْا كِسْوَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ سَاقِطًا And if they see that a fragment of the heaven is falling down, قَلْ يَقُولُوا صَعَابٌ مَرْكُومٌ They will say, it's the only clouds amassed. Just as, you know, the قَوْمِ عَاد, when that chastisement of Allah came, they thought that this is cloud, it will rain. They were enjoying. فَذَرْهُمْ حَتَّى يُلَاقُوا يَوْمَهُمُ الَّذِي فِيهِ يُسْعَقُونَ So leave them, O Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Leave them alone. Till they meet their day, in which they shall be thunderstruck. يَوْمَ لَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا On that day, when their plotting will avail them of nothing. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ Nor they will be helped. وَإِنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا عَذَابًا دُونَ ذَلِكَ And surely for those who are doing these evils, committing these evil deeds, there is a chastisement before that also. That chastisement, final chastisement, عَذَابَ الْأَكْبَرِ Before that, small chastisements can come. Then this can be the chastisement of the hereafter, before that, the chastisements in this world, and number two, in the graves. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But most of them know not. وَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ So be patient and wait for the command of your Lord. When after sabr there is this lam, وَاسْبِرْ لِ It means wait. Don't take any hasty step. You have to wait the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, Hazrat Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam only committed this mistake. He didn't wait for the command of Allah to come to permit him to leave his nation and go away. He went away by his own, on his own. So he was punished. وَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ So you have to wait for the command of your Lord. فَإِنَّكَ بِعَيُنِنَا Because you are in our sight. We are seeing you. Whatever is happening to you, we know it, we are seeing. وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ حِينَ تَقُومُ And you glorify your Lord with his praise. When you arise in the night from the sleep, or you arise in the day to pray. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَصَبِّحُ And in the hours of the night, glorify him. وَإِدْبَارَ النُّجُومُ And at the setting of the stars, when the stars set, now the night is going, the dawn is come. So that is also a time when you should have tasbih and tahmid. Now the setting of the stars, with the mention of the setting of the stars, this surah At-Tur ended. And Surah Al-Najm starts with this. Surah Al-Najm and Surah Al-Qamar, they are a pair. You will find in Surah Al-Qamar, the Ambaul Rusul, the big news of the messengers of Allah. But in Surah Al-Najm, it's all Tazkir bi Ala Illah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَالنَّجْمِ إِذَا هَوَى. By the star when it goes down. مَا ضَلَّ صَاحِبُكُمْ وَمَا غَوَى. Your companion, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has not gone astray, nor has he erred. Don't think he's committing some mistake when he says, I saw the angel. Don't think he has been possessed by some evil spirit. No, no. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. And he does not speak out of his own desire. In huwa illa wahyun yuha. Surely this Quran is nothing but a revelation revealed to him. Allamahu shadidul quwa. And he was taught by one who has very mighty power. And this is denoting Hazrat Jibrail alayhi salatu wassalam. Shadidul quwa. Zu mirra. He is strong and perfect. Fastawa. So he stood straight. وَهُوَ بِالْأُفُقِ الْعَالَى. And he was on the uppermost horizon. ثُمَّ دَنَى. Then he drew near. فَتَدَلَّى. And hung down, suspended. فَكَانَ قَابَ قَوْسَنِ غَدْنَى. Then he was within two bows length, or even nearer. فَأَوْحَى إِلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ مَا أَوْحَىٰ. Then he revealed to the servant of God what he revealed. These ayat are interpreted in many ways. But I agree with those who think this incident was when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw the angel Jibreel in his own original angelic form in the horizon. This is given in, you know, authentic ahadith. He was coming down from the Jabalul Nur, the Mount of Light. And there is the cave of Hira at the top of that mountain of light. He was coming down. So he heard someone say, Ya Muhammad. He saw there, right, left, front, back, nobody was there to be seen. So he had some fear. What is it? Then he walked a few steps more. Then there was again, Ya Muhammad. Again the same thing. He looked to the left, to the right. Nobody to be seen. So his fear was increased. Then after a few steps again, Ya Muhammad. Now, suddenly his eyes rose into the horizon. And he saw Jibreel alayhi salatu wassalam. And he was in the full form of an angel. Otherwise, when Jibreel came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the form of human beings, and Dahya Kalbi radiallahu ta'ala anhu was one of the very beautiful, handsome companions of the Prophet, and usually Jibreel came in the form of Dahya radiallahu anhu. But here in Jibreel was, whole the horizon was full of him. This angel, how can we say, and how he recognized it in Jibreel, because when the first one he had come, he had seen him. But that was Banan Nome Wal Yaqza. At that time, he was neither sleeping nor awake. In between the two conditions, semi-sleeping condition, the first one he came. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Khalaq al-insana min alaq. When Jibreel hugged thrice Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said Iqra, and the reply was, I am not a qari. I don't read. So he hugged him. So now he recognized. But then he was full of, you know, fear. The awe of Hazrat. But then Hazrat Jibreel came down. And his relation, his connection with the heaven was not broken. As if something, you know, hangs down. And then he sent the wahi. And what was that wahi? The first seven ayat of Surah Al-Muddassir. Ya ayyuha al-Muddassir, qum fa'anzir, wa rabbaka fa'kabbir, wa siyabaka fa'tahhir, wa rujza fa'jur, wa la tamnun tastaqsir, wa li rabbika fa'sbir. So this is the shan-e-nuzul of these ayat which appear in the beginning of Surah Al-Muddassir. Ma kadab al-fu'adu mara. The heart didn't lie, belie that what he saw. Does it mean? Sometimes you see something, but you have doubt. But what I am seeing, is it okay? It is correct? Am I awake or I am seeing a dream? Aanch-e-mi bineem ya rab bebedari siyab-e khab. I am seeing it in actuality or in a dream. But whatever the eyes of Muhammad saw, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his heart confirmed, not belied it. أَفَتُمَارُونَهُ عَلَى مَا يَرَى. So, will you then dispute with him as to what he saw? وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ نَزْلَةً أُخْرَى. And he had seen him once more. Jibreel, only twice Muhammad saw him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his own original form of the angel. One was this, on the horizon, and the other was on the night of ascension, when Jibreel took him. But till the Sidratul Muntaha, he was disguised. But at the Sidratul Muntaha, he presented himself to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his full angelic form. And that was the second time. When Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam as a full angel, in original form of an angel. وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ نَزْلَةً أُخْرَىٰ. And he had seen him once more also, in the Sidratil Muntaha, by the low tree of the utmost boundary. That is the actually boundary. Lahut, Nasut, you know. Beyond that, Jibreel couldn't go. So, that was the boundary. This world of Amr and the world of creation. Is yaksha sidrata ma yaksha indaha jannatul bawa. Near that low tree, there is the garden of abode. That is also very near. Indaha jannatul bawa. Is yaksha sidrata ma yaksha. When the low tree was shrouded, by what was surrounding it? You can't understand. And we can't explain in your language what was surrounding it. What was coming down on that tree. The anwar, the lights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our language cannot express them. So, ma yaksha. Is yaksha siddhata? Ma yaksha. When you know that tree was covered by what was it covered by? Ma zagha al-basar wa ma tagha. This ayah is very important. The eye swerved not, nor transgressed. What does it mean? If you try to look a very strong light directly, your eye will not be able to stand it. You will turn. It didn't happen with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His eyes kept seeing. He had that capacity. But also, there are limits. If you are in the presence of someone who is very big, very high, you don't lift your eyes more than a certain limit. So this was also there. The eyes of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not cross the limits of abdiya, ma tagha, neither transgressed the limits of abdiya. He was abd of Allah. Allah was the Lord of him. So, though both things, you know, neither the sight swerved, nor it transgressed. And there is a very beautiful couplet of Iqbal. And I could understand this ayah only after reading that couplet. Aine visal mein mujhe hausla-e nazar na tha. Hausla-e nazar, the courage to see. Here, the opposite of this, Iqbal has put there. Aine visal mein mujhe hausla-e nazar na tha. When I was very close to my beloved, I didn't have the courage to see her. See her or him, whatever it is. Garche bahana ju rahi meri nigahe be-adab. Although my, you know, sight was not muaddab, and it tried to, you know, transgress. So I was trying to transgress, but I couldn't see. عین وصال میں مجھے حوصلہ نظر نہ تھا گرچہ بہانہ جو رہی میری نگاہ بے ادب. But here ما زاغ البصر وما طغى. Neither the sight swerved nor transgressed the limit. لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى. Verily he saw the biggest signs of his Lord. There was a controversy whether the Prophet saw him, Allah, or not. Quran doesn't confirm it. Quran doesn't say Muhammad saw Allah. Here also, greatest signs of his Lord, the greatest signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were there at that juncture, you know, of this world and the other world. فَرَأَيْتُمُ اللَّهَ وَالْعُزَىٰ. Now this was actually a description of the heavenly part of Miraj, the ascension. It had two components. One, this worldly, from Masjid al-Haram at Makkah to Masjid al-Aqsa at Jerusalem. Then from there, ascension to the heavens. So this is mentioned here. And the first is mentioned in the beginning, first ayah of Surah Bani Israel. أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَىٰ. Now the deities that they had concocted. Have you ever considered the Lat and Uzza? وَمَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَىٰ. And the Manat, the other third. أَلَكُمُ الزَّكَرُ وَلَهُ الْأُنْثَىٰ. Are for you males and for him, Allah, females. تِلْكَ إِذَنْ قِسْمَةٌ زِيزَىٰ. Now this is a very unjust division. إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا أَسْمَاءٌ سَمَّيْتُمُوهَا أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمْ. These are only names. You have concocted them. You and your fathers. مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ. Allah has not at all sent down any authority or any proof for them. إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا ظَنَّ. They are only conjecturing. They are following only their guess and conjectures. وَمَا تَعْوَى الْأَنفُسِ. And also what their animal souls desire. وَلَقَدْ جَاهُمْ مِنْ رَبِّهُمُ الْهُدَىٰ. But now to them the real guidance has come from their Lord. أَمْ لِلْإِنسَانِ مَا تَمَنَّىٰ. Shall man have whatever he wishes? فَلِلَّهِ الْآخِرَةُ وَالْأُولَىٰ. But in Allah's hands are the hereafter as well as the first, that is this life. This life is also the life in the head of Allah. He gives to whomsoever He likes more, and He gives to whomsoever likes less. وَكَمْ مِنْ مَلَكٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ لَا تُغْنِي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ شَيْئًا. And how many angels are there in the heavens? Their intercession will not be of any avail whatsoever. إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ يَعْذَنَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَرْضَىٰ. Except that Allah gives leave to whomsoever He wishes and for whomsoever He is pleased with. Two conditions. Leave to the intercessor. Yes, you can say something. And about the person, about whom you are going to say, there is express permission needed. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. Verily those who don't believe in the hereafter, لَيُسَمُّونَ الْمَلَائِكَةَ تَسْمِيَةَ الْأُسْرَىٰ. They are naming the angels with female names. وَمَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ. They have no knowledge of it. إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا ظَنَّ. They are following only their conjectures and nothing else. وَإِنَّ الظَّنَّ لَا يَغْنِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ شَيْئًا. And you, this guessing and conjectures cannot avail you against truth. فَعَرِضْ عَنْ مَنْ تَوَلَّىٰ. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you turn your attention from those who are arid amman tawalla, who are turning their backs towards you, an zikrina, from our admonition. Walam yurid illa al-hayat al-dunya. And he doesn't desire anything except this world. Zalika mablaghuhum min al-ilm. This is their attainment, final knowledge, final attainment. They can know only this world, not the hereafter. ذَلِكَ مَبْلَغُهُ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ. إِنَّ رَبَّكَهُ عَالَمُ بِمَنْ ضَلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. Verily your Lord knows better who has gone astray from His path. وَهُوَ عَالَمُ بِمَنْ اِهْتَدَىٰ. And He knows better who is rightly guided. وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And verily to Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever in the earth. لَيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسَاءُوا بِمَا عَمِلُوا. So that he recompenses those who did wrong things, bad things, for what they did. وَيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا بِالْحُسْنَى. And he should reward those who did good deeds with the fairest reward. الَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِسْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشِ. Who are those who avoid the great sins and indecencies? Now this subject, I got it noted in Surah to Shura. الَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِسْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشِ وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوا هُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. So this is a very important subject. And this is the third time it is appearing in Quran. First of all, it came in Surah An-Nisa, then in Surah Shura, and then third time here. Greater sins. You take care of greater sins. The smaller sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pardon and excuse. But whosoever is very sensitive about very small things, generally we see that he is committing greater sins. He is involved in riba, interest, usury, but he's very sensitive about, you know, he has raised his hands or not, where he has, you know, folded his hands, here or there. About these things, they are very, very particular, very sensitive. الَّذِينَ يَتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِسْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشَ إِلَّا اللَّمَمْ. Who avoid great sins and indecencies, except small offenses. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ وَاسِعُ الْمَغْفِرَةِ. Definitely your Lord has very vast forgiveness. هو عَلَمُ بِكُمْ. He very well knew you. إِذْ أَنْشَاكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. When he was raising you from the earth. وَإِذْ أَنْتُمْ أَجِنَّةٌ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ. Also, when you were embryos in the wombs of your mothers. فَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. So do not hold yourself purified. Allah knows you. You were there. You were a drop of sperm. And then, you know, this fetus in the womb of the mother. هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. He very well knows who is really God-fearing. أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي تَوَلَّى. So, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, have you considered who turned away? Mostly people think that this is the citation of an example of Walid bin Mughira. He was one of the big chiefs of Quraysh, a very wealthy person. He had many sons. Khalid ibn Walid, radiyallahu anhu, Saifun min Suyufillah, he was son of Walid bin Mughira. Khalid bin Walid, Walid bin Mughira. He came to Islam very near, very near. He was just about to accept Islam. But then, you know, he thought of his position, that he will be boycotted in his society. His position won't remain the same. So this got him stuck and didn't accept openly. But he had reached very close. أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي تَوَلَّى. Have you considered the person who has turned back? وَعَتَى قَلِيلًا وَاقْدَى. And he leaned towards believing for a while, but then stopped. عَتَى قَلِيلًا وَاقْدَى. عَنْدَهُ إِلْمُ الْغَيْبِ فَهُوَ يَرَى. Does he have the knowledge of the unseen, so that he sees it? أَمْ لَمْ يُنَبَّى بِمَا فِي صُحُفِ الْأُولَى. صُحُفِ مُوسَى. Was he not informed of what was in the scriptures of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam? وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ الَّذِي وَفَّى. And the scriptures of Ibrahim, he who faithfully fulfilled Allah's commandments, and he passed all the tests that Allah asked him to pass through. Allah taziru wazanatum wizra ukhra, that no burdened soul bears the burden of another. Wa laysa lil insani illa ma sa'a, and that there shall be for no man anything except that for which he makes effort. Wa nasayahu safa yura. And that his effort shall soon be before him. It will be seen. Summa yujzahu al-jazaa al-awfa. Summa yujzahu al-jazaa al-awfa. And then he shall be recompensed and rewarded with a fullest recompense. Wa anna ila rabbika al-muntaha. And that the final end is unto your Lord. Your return is towards your Lord. Wa annahu huwa adhaka wa abka. And that it is he who makes someone laugh and someone weep. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَا. And that he is one who put to death and who keeps alive. وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنَ الزَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْسَى. It is He who has created pairs, spouses, the male and the female, مِن نُطْفَةٍ, from the same sperm drop, إِذَا تُمْنَى, when it is emitted out. وَأَنَّ عَلَيْهِ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُخْرَى. And that on Him it is the responsibility of another creation, is due upon Him. Because the reward of the people, that is due on Him to be paid to the people. So, عَلَيْهِ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُخْرَى. It is binding on Him, so to say. Although we can't say anything is binding on Allah. But كَتَبَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ رَحْمَةً لَيَجْمَعَنَّكُمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bound Himself by His mercy that He will definitely gather you on the Day of Judgment. Why? Those who suffered for My sake, if they are not rewarded, it means it's the biggest injustice. If there is no resurrection, if there is no life hereafter, those people who suffered for the sake of truth, who sacrificed, well, they go unrewarded. This is against justice. So it is must for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to create again. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَغْنَى وَأَغْنَى. And that it is He who enriches and bestows contentment. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ رَبُّ الشَّيْرَى. And that He is the Lord of the star Sirius. Sirius was a star which the Arabs used to worship. وَأَنَّهُ أَهْلَكَ عَادَ الْأُولَى. And that He destroyed the former Aad, was Samuda, and also the Samud, the nation of Samud, فَمَا أَبْقَى. And He spared none. وَقَوْمَ نُوحٍ مِّن قَبْلِ. And before them, the people of Nuh, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوهُمْ أَظْلَمَ وَأَطْغَى. Verily they were exceedingly evil and excessively inordinate. وَالْمُؤْتَفِقَةَ أَهْوَى. And those subverted townships, He overthrew them, the Sodom and Gomorrah. فَغَشَّاهَا مَا غَشَّاهَا. After they were overturned, then they were covered with that with which they were covered. فَبِأَيَّ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ تَتَمَارَىٰ. So, which of the graces of your Lord you will dispute and belie? هَذَا نَزِيرٌ مِنَ النُّذُرِ الْأُولَىٰ. This, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is also a warner from amongst the former warners which had been coming. Musa, Isa, Hud, Saleh, they were the warners. Azifatil Azifa. The near hour has come very near. Laysa laha min dunillahi kashifa. None beside Allah can avert it. Afa min hadhal hadith ta'jabun. So do you wonder at this discourse of recital, this revelation of Quran? فَتَزْحَكُونَ وَلَا تَبْكُونَ. And you laugh and not weep. You should weep for what is in store for you. What chastisement you will be getting. And you are laughing. فَتَزْحَكُونَ وَلَا تَبْكُونَ. And you are laughing and not weeping. وَأَنْتُمْ سَامِدُونَ. And you are just amusing yourselves, playing, mocking. فَاسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ وَاعْبُدُوا. So prostrate before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship Him and love Him and obey Him. This is ayah of sajda, so make a sajda. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ وَنَفَعَنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِالْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ.
الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. a Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing Iona is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about Iona, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.